Leroy's Pokemon Sapphire Walkthrough, Part 23. Alright, now let's continue along and fight this dude. Can you guess why it's so cool around here? Didn't know it was so cool, but whatever. But anyways, we're gonna fight Youngster Neil. I almost said Nunkster Yeel. but yeah, he's got a trap inch, so this will be pretty easy. Let's kill it with Tree Ninja. And yeah. So Trapinch is a really interesting Pokemon. It has insanely high attack for like the stage that it's at. It's at its first stage evolution. It actually lowers its attack when it evolves, but then it evolves into a Flygon, which is really awesome. And I'm gonna switch out for Linoon. But yeah, if you want to get those, you can get them pretty soon, actually, later in the game, once you get into the desert area, which you can do after beating the next gym. And of course, everyone loves Flygon so much, and so many people think I'm going to catch a Flygon. Well, you'll just have to wait to see if I do or not. But anyways, in the meantime, we'll just kill this Linoon here. Oh, and you're going to sand attack me, but it doesn't matter, because Vital Throw never misses. And yeah. So that thing's gonna die, and we can continue along with the route. And Jelly Belly is getting up a level, that's nice. Alright, now, let's see here. I don't want to fight that kid over there for some reason, I don't know why. Anyways, we got some trainer tips, blah blah blah. And guys, I'm really sorry, but I kind of really have to go to the bathroom right now, so I will be right back. Alright, sorry about that, but I'm back now. I don't think that's ever happened to me in the middle of a video, but it's okay. And let's fight this girl. Filthy, yucky, volcanic ash for your dear Numble. Isn't your Numble already in a Pokeball? Does it really... You need to, like... Whatever. I don't understand the logic of these people. Like, your Numble's in a Pokeball. It's not getting any ash on it. And even if it is, it's a Fire-type Pokemon anyways. Let's see here. Actually, I think I'm just gonna stay in with Tree Ninja. I don't really have anything much better to change into, so I'll just go Pursuit, I guess. Because, of course, Bolt Seed won't work. Oh, wait, crap, I keep forgetting. Numble's ground type. It's not even... Okay, never mind. Grass type is neutral. I forgot that, like, two videos ago that Numble was a ground type. Or maybe that was last video, I don't know. But yeah, grass types will do neutral damage. Which is kind of weird because you don't think about that because you think of it more as a fire type. So you wouldn't assume, you know, grass would work. But it actually is, which is kind of interesting. So yeah, go ahead and use your grass types on Numble and Camerupt. And Magnitude. Magnitude's a really interesting move. I'm going to be learning it very soon with my Numble, which is kind of awesome because it's a good ground type move. What it does is it gives you a random number on a scale of like 1 to 10. I don't actually think you can get 1. I think it's like a scale of 3 to 10. And the higher the number, the more power it does. So if you get like a 10, it's going to be insanely powerful. Like more powerful than Earthquake. But if you get one of the low numbers, it's not going to do like jack diddly squat. So yeah. And she's so exhausted. I never understand what's so exhausting about watching your Pokemon, like, lose a battle, but whatever. Let's see. I'm gonna switch up Tambora to the second slot to do this double battle right here. And, yeah, we can fight these little girls. anyways, yeah, in this route over here, by the way, since I didn't mention it, you can find Spinda, which is a normal type, and Skarmory. And if you're playing Ruby and Sapphire, you can get Sandshrew. However, you can't get Sandshrew and Emerald, and you can get a Slugma and Emerald, but not Ruby and Sapphire. So yeah, Skarmory, I'm going to talk a bit about Skarmory in a minute, because there's a lot of people asking about Skarmory, so I'm just going to mention that after this battle. But anyways, my strategy in these double battles is always to go after one Pokemon at a time. Just because if you can, you know, kill one of them, you'll have a 2-on-1 advantage, which makes it a lot easier. But of course, you know, there's exceptions, like, if you have super effective moves on each Pokemon, you might as well just go for the damage, but in situations like this, it's better to just get rid of one at a time, I think. So yeah. And Whismur's gonna howl, it's gonna raise up its attack. Not that it makes a difference, though, because it's gonna die now. Bullet Seed and Ember. I wonder, if you use Bullet Seed and Ember at the same time, would the fire, like, destroy the Bullet Seed and turn it into, like, a giant, like, Bullet Flame Seed that would just do, like, massive amounts of damage? I don't know. Maybe that's just my crazy imagination. Oh yeah, so they're gonna go collect more ashes, and I think I'll talk about that later because there's something you can do with collecting all these ashes. Anyways, here's a Max Aether. Now back to Skarmory. Pretty much, like, everybody and their mom was like, oh, you're gonna catch a Skarmory. Oh, you should use a Skarmory. Actually, up until about a week ago, I was going to plan on using a Skarmory on my team, but just recently I changed my mind, so I'm actually not going to. But seriously, like, everybody was like, Skarmory, Skarmory, Skarmory. I'm like, you know what, Skarmory is just way too overused, and, like, everyone uses it. But seriously, like, every single person was, like, guessing Skarmory. I was like, holy crap, everyone knows I'm using Skarmory. But then I decided to change my mind, so yeah. And Ninja Boy Lung? Was his name Lung? Who names their kid Lung? It's like, oh, what? Look at this lovely new baby. What should we name him? How about John? How about Tim? How about Lung? Whatever. I'm sorry if your name is Lung. I just like making fun of names sometimes. I'm sure no one's name is Lung, though. Like, seriously, that's not even a name. That's like a body part. It's like naming yourself, like, Throat or something. Or whatever. So yeah, we're getting up levels, which is awesome, and we're fighting some more bug Pokemon, which makes it pretty easy for Numble. And actually, while I'm doing this, I have, like, a name book, so I'm just gonna see if that's even in there, the name of Lung. And I'm not seeing it, really. I don't think it's in here anyways. But anyways, Ninjask is a crazy fast Pokemon, in case you didn't know. It's probably, like, one of the fastest in any of the games, except for, like, Deoxys. But yeah, every turn it has an ability that boosts up its speed, so... I mean, it's not that big of a deal, because, you know, it's probably not going to pose much of a threat offensively, but yeah, just kind of crazy with its speed. So yeah. And we defeated the Lung. Alright. So, oh yeah, the battle's already over. And what's with the really long hair? It's like, what the heck? And he has a sword, too. Like, holy crap, who gave that little kid a sword? Anyways, go inside this house. Now, this is what I was talking about with collecting ashes. If you talk to this guy, he will give you an item called the Soot Sack. Now what you can do is you get this item, then you can walk around in the grass out there, and each step you collect the ashes, and if you collect enough ashes, you can exchange them for items. Now the items are actually really great, and a lot of people don't know about this, but you can get items that are really similar to like the Pokéflute back in the first generation. You can get stuff to heal up sleep, you can get stuff to heal up attraction and confusion. So it's like a never-ending item, kind of like the Pokéflute, to heal different types of statuses. So it's a really great thing. I'd actually recommend going around collecting the ashes and then going to that guy because you can get some great items. Anyways, here's TM32 in one of those random hidden spots. So yeah, I don't remember what that is actually, so I'm going to check. I want to say it's double team. All right. Now, just because I'm not a cheap noob, I'm not going to use that. But, you know, if you have no morals and you want to use double team, go ahead. You have no morals, you use double team. Anyways, this is youngster Dylan. He has one Pokemon and Aaron, so this should be pretty easy. Aaron's like a defensive powerhouse, in case you didn't know. Like, physical defense, anyways. And if he uses iron defense, you're pretty much screwed if you're using physical moves. But yeah, we're just gonna use Ember. It'll probably be a 4-hit KO. And a couple more embers will take this thing out. A couple more embers will really take this thing out. I don't know why I said it a little weird like that. Anyways, apparently Aaron just wants to keep raising its defense. I always thought it was really weird that Aaron, like, I don't know why they gave it the name Aaron, because it's like a real human name. Like, it's spelled different, but just kind of interesting. I don't know. If anyone knows, like, why that name, or why it's named Aaron, or where, like, the origin of the name is, please post a comment, because I'm kind of curious. Anyways, right up here is the new town, and yeah, it's what we're going to be checking out, and I think we actually have time to tour it right now, but first I'm going to go heal up my Pokemon, so yeah. Alright, now this is Falerbo Town, and I have no idea if I'm pronouncing that right. I actually think it's pronounced Fall Arbor Town, but correct me if I'm wrong. Anyways, it is a farm community with small gardens. Now, back when we were in Verdanturf Town, I said that was basically the most worthless town in the game. This town gives it a run for its money, because there's literally nothing here. Like, no gyms or anything. Now, probably what makes it a little bit more useful than Verdanturf Town is this guy, the Move Tutor. He's pretty much the only important person here. If you have a heart scale, which you can get, you know, deep sea diving way later in the game, you can give it to him and he will reteach you old moves and stuff like that. And if you look in here, you can find a nugget, which a lot of people don't know, even though it's kind of an obvious spot, but people just don't look there. Anyways, right here is a cool house, but you can't do anything in it right now. It's Professor Cosmo's house, but he's off with Team Aqua exploring, so we will come back here later. And yeah, the marks right here, I'll probably buy some items later, actually. And let's see, one last thing. We'll come in Route 114 and go inside this house, and this place is kind of crazy. There's this, like, freak way back here who digs tunnels, like, as far and deep as he can. And he's, like, way at the end, like, some psycho dude. And he's like, I'm the fossil maniac, wah, I like digging holes in the back of my house. So yeah, he talks about fossils. You can come back to this guy later. You can get fossils later in the desert place, but yeah, that's later on. What you can do in this house that's kind of, I guess it's not really important, but one thing that's kind of cool is you can talk to this guy, and he'll give you the TM for Dig, which is 28. So yeah, if you have a ground-type Pokemon and doesn't know any good ground-type moves, Dig's not bad, and I might teach that to Numble, I don't know. But anyways, I think that's pretty much it for now. We got a lot done in this video, and next time we're going to be heading towards the next route, so stay tuned for more. And I'll see you all next time.